What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Team Fish Knuckles YouTube channel. Today we have another regional support, and this time around it's from somebody who's actually in Team Fish Knuckles, and that is Drew, who got top 8 at Fort Wayne with the Seismitoad Giratina deck, of course, here. Now, Seismitoad Giratina deck is just a very strong deck. We've seen a top 8 a lot over the past 3 weekends here. You know, with Seismitoad to idle lock your opponents, Energy Denial with the Crush Hammer, Team Flare Grunts. Overall, really consistent list here. But hopefully, you enjoyed the interview, and thanks for watching. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Team Fish Knuckles YouTube channel. Today, we have another region support, and what's your name?
Drew Kate.
Alrighty, and what regionals are we talking about?
The Fort Wayne, Indiana regionals.
Alrighty, now, we know that you play the Seismitoad Giratina deck. But before we talk about your list and everything, what decks did you play against and how the matches go?
Okay, so round one I played against Yveltal, and they got bad draws. It was a 2-0 game. I can't remember what I played against round two. Round three I played against Manectric, and they also didn't get stuff going, and I got the lockout, and that was a 2-0 game. Game 4, I played against Sableye Bunnelby, and Game 1 came down really close. I was down to my very last special energy, but I ended up pulling it off and winning. And then Game 2, I got the lockout really fast and just won really hard. And then Game 5, I played against Yveltal again, and I lost the first game because I started Hoopa and, prized, a bunch of, good stuff. And it was just really bad, so I ended up having to scoop that game to make time for the next two games. And I ended up winning the next two games pretty decently. So that was, kind of close because I lost the first one. And then game six was the stream game. I played on stream against Bats Toads, and he didn't set up well either games. It was pretty much a stomp.
Yeah, the Quake Punch was too strong. I remember that game, you just Quake a Punch and he hit a bunch of items, and I guess I'll lose.
Yeah, I got a Getsis for 6 that game. And then game 7, I played against Night March, and I don't remember how. I'm pretty sure I won game 1 and then lost game 2 and it was really close, and then I won game 3 and it was really close, so it was pretty back and forth. Game 8 I played against Yveltal again. Game 1 I got set up really fast and just won. Game 2 I prized all 4 of my DCE, but I still managed to pull out that game. I still managed to win that game, even though I prized all 4 of my DCE. So yeah, that was pretty cool. And then round 9, or no, it's round 8, I played against Cobalion, Giratina, Bronzong, which, should wreck me, really, really hard, and game 1 was really, really close, but I ended up winning game 1 just barely by getting, he didn't get set up that well, so I ended up pulling out game 1. Game 2, I got stomped really hard. And game 3, we didn't get to finish, so we tied. And then, actually, I got round 7 and round 8 mixed up.
That's okay. That's okay.
Swap those two.
Yeah, yeah.
And then game 9, I played against Jimmy with Vespa Queen. And game 1, I think I ended up winning that one. And then game, it was really close too. And then game 2, I got stomped. And then game 3, I got stomped. And then, so I ended day 1 at 7-1-1 with 4th seed.
Okay. All right.
Which was pretty nice. And then going into day two, round one, I played against the Cobalion Giratina deck that I had already played against. And I somehow, like, game one lasted a really long time, and I somehow managed to pull out game one and win that. And then we didn't have time to finish game two, so I just won that.
One item, yeah.
Yeah, and then I played against Jimmy again and his Vespa Queen Flareon, and game one he won, and then I got stomped on, and then game two he started with like a really terrible hand, and I just got like set up and ended up winning that way. And then game three, he didn't get any battle compressors out turn one, and then I got toad turn two and just won that way.
And for those who don't know, he's talking about Jimmy O'Brien, who actually won regionals the weekend before too, if you didn't know that. So
And then I ID'd my next three games to secure top eight. But the last round it counted as a win because Dean Nizam, right?
Yeah, Nizam.
He got DQ'd, so it counted as a win instead of a tie. So I ended, technically, I should have been like 9-1 and like 4, but I ended 10-1-3 at second seed. Like my resistance was really good, and I was in top 8, like guaranteed anyway, but it just kind of happened that I was second seed.
Yeah. Who was first seed?
Daylin.
Okay. And for those who don't know,
Daylin Dockery.
Daylin and Drew are both from Tennessee, so yeah. Tennessee got first and second seed. There we go.
Yeah.
That'd be a good shout out.
And then I played against Matt Price in top 8, and game 1 I got set up for, like, it's mirror match. Like, mirror match is, like, stupid. I got set up first in the mirror match with, like, toads and stuff. So I won game one. Game two, I started with a really disgusting hand. It was, like, a lone Seismitoad and a lone Giratina. And turn one, he headringers both of them. And I don't draw any draw cards for, like, 3 turns. So I scoop that game. And then we go on to game 3. And I get set up really well turn one, and he kind of gets set up too. And I whiff DCE two turns in a row, so I couldn't get the toad set up before he did, and he got it out first, and he started that, and my bench was full, and I kept like whiffing stuff for the rest of the game because my toad ended up dying, and he kept the lock going, so... That's how it ended.
Oh, well. I mean, but top 8's still great at regionals, so congratulations, sir. Alright. So, I guess...
Yeah, it's pretty fun.
Yeah, exactly. It's always fun playing regionals. I guess the very first question is, why did you decide to play the Seismitoad Giratina deck?
Well, it just has, like, really good matchups, like, all around the board. It doesn't, like, super, like, auto-loss to, like, really anything. Mm-hmm. Like, even with the Cobalion Giratina deck, which I was pretty scared of. It did pretty well against. But it just had like really good matchups. So.
Okay. All right. There you go. all right. So I guess the first question about your deck here is you played Jirachi, you played a Hoopa, and you played a Shaymin. Which was your favorite like support Pokemon during the weekend?
Definitely Hoopa. Hoopa's just like so good. Because, like, you just get, like, all your stuff out, and I don't know. I didn't, like, end up prizing Koopa that much, so that was nice.
Yeah. I was going to ask if you wanted to play a second Hoopa, but if you said you never...
Yeah, like, I thought, I had considered playing a second Hoopa, but I just couldn't fit in the space, and I was like, I don't really want to have to play a second Hoopa. So I just kind of, like, was like, I'll deal with it.
All right. Now, you did play a Hex Maniac, and besides that, that's, like, your only... Oh, I guess you played Team Flareon as well. Which one did you, like more, the Hex Maniac or Team Flareon?
I mean,
And you played Getsis, too. And you played Getsis, sorry. Yeah, and the Getsis, yeah.
I mean, I like all those cards. It just really depends on the matchup, like which one's like more important. Like there's some matchups where like against Yveltal, you can like shut off their abilities for like a turn, and then they can't like dark like whatever Darkrai's ability is that like gets
Darkrai.
them retreat. You can like lock them out of that for a turn, and then just like keep them from retreating, so you get like a guaranteed knockout. And just like they all have like their matchups against like Getsis is like really good against like Blastoise, which I actually didn't play against, and like really trainer heavy decks. So,
Okay, but which is your favorite one?
which is my
Not
favorite?
yeah.
They're all my favorite.
No, they can't all be your favorites. You always have, if you have three kids, you still have a kid that's your favorite.
Wow, okay.
Like, if you were playing blind, you couldn't see your opponent's side of the field, you have no idea what they're playing, and you Ultra Ball for Jirachi to pick a supporter, what tech supporter are you picking turn one?
I mean, I guess the Getsis was pretty cool, especially that the one game on stream where I got like a 6-card Getsis. Just like the times when it worked really well. So,
All right. So Getsis is the answer. There you go. See, you had a favorite. You just had to
I
think
mean,
about
they're all
it.
close favorites. Like they all
Yeah,
serve their purpose.
that's true. All right. Now, besides the second Hoopa, was there anything like you wish you had played in the deck, but you just didn't? Like you're like, oh, if only I played this card, it could help me out right now.
So like Tool Scrapper and like Enhanced Hammer would have been cool, but I didn't end up fitting them in the deck, and I didn't feel like I needed them too much, but those are the only things I'd really consider
Okay.
extra.
Yeah. All right. Now,
But I pretty much like where my list is.
that was like pretty much like perfect as it is.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Now, with the Crush Hammers, do you feel like you're more like 50-50? Did you flip more heads? Did you flip more tails? Like, how do you think it went?
I feel like it went about 50-50 for most of the day, which is like all I can ask for. So.
Yeah, that's true. If you get what you're supposed to get, then good, man. All right, now you did only play like three double dragon energies, which is pretty like standard nowadays. But did you ever wish you played like a fourth one, or did you really not attack with Giratina that much?
I didn't. I don't feel like I needed the fourth one. Giratina, you don't attack with like that much to warrant needing like a fourth. But 3 was a good solid number. I wouldn't go above or below that.
Okay, all right. So, how many championship points are you at right now?
97.
97. So you
Yeah.
practically like a third of the way there. If
Yeah.
the invite is 300, I guess is the big question here right now that we don't know.
Yeah.
So coming up for cities, if it's expanded, are you gonna stick with the Seismitoad Giratina deck, or do you think there's something else that's piquing your interest that you'd rather play?
There's a few other things I want to test, but I'll definitely probably end up playing Giratina, Seismitoad Giratina, at least a few times.
Yeah, true. Just solid deck. Now, okay, besides expanded, do you think Seismitoad Giratina still has a chance in standard? Even though you don't have like the lasers, you don't have the Keldeo. We're supposed to get back the Floodstone, so at least we'll have that coming back to us.
I don't think it's as good in standard. I haven't tested it nearly as much in standard, so I'll have to see. But it doesn't look quite as strong in standard, but I'll have to test it more.
Okay, all right. Now, do you want to give any shout-outs to anybody?
Team Fish Knuckles. I'll give a shout out to Fish
Yeah.
Knuckles. Yeah, I guess a shout out to Randall, Leslie, and Dustin, who I rode up with. 2 regionals, I probably wouldn't have gotten up there if they hadn't have taken me, so shout out to them.
All righty. Well,
And
I
everyone
think.
who's like in Murfreesboro, Pokemon Murfreesboro.
No, you gotta name
So
everybody now. If you're gonna say Murfreesboro, you just.
no. I just
No.
everybody if you're in Murfreesboro, you play Pokemon, shout out to you.
Alrighty, man. Well, thank you so much for doing this interview. Congrats once again on top 8. That's pretty amazing there. Because what, it was like 400 and like 70 something masters?
Yeah, it was a lot. I think it was like a record.
Yeah, it
That's
definitely was a record. Like almost 500 is like. I know it was close to 500, which is crazy. But like. 400, like almost 500 players. You got top eight, so like, we'll take that for sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
So. Alrighty, man. Once again, congrats on getting top eight. Thanks for everybody for watching the interview. Hope you learned something new about the Seismitoad Giratina deck. Maybe, you know, maybe had some input about Standard. I know Drew didn't know that much about it, but, you know, we'll learn some more here coming the months. We got, like, 1 month till City starts, so look out for those for sure. Thanks again, Drew, for doing this interview. Hope everybody has a great day. Alrighty.